Hello, baby.
Hello. Oh, no.
Hey? Oh, no. What do you mean, oh, no?
Look at my money.
Yeah, well, we've only just got that baby. You're not going to have blinking model hair when you get up, are you?
No, I'm not in a good mood.
Why?
Your flight's been cancelled again.
Our holiday's been cancelled again, hasn't it,
Pat? For the second time.
For the second time, yep. And how far away will we be? 23 days? 25 days?
22 days.
22 days away. Never mind, baby.
It's not never mind, though, is it?
So the time at the moment is 7:46 in the morning, and we're just going to have our cup of tea. Just been going through some emails and stuff, and what are you doing?
Oh, I think I'm giving you green tea, aren't I?
Have you? That's all right, I don't mind. I'll have a cup of green tea, baby, I'm not bothered. Oh, well, I'll tell you what, baby, we're going to sit outside and have our cup of tea, how about that? Yeah?
Yeah.
Let's go outside, folks. Right, let's go outside. These chains are working well, show, aren't they?
Yeah, great spend.
Come on, baby, out you come.
Oh, we're in the shade.
Yeah, well, we go sit over there. The sun's nearly going to come over. As you see, folks, we're nearly getting there with the patio now. We've got just a few more tiles in that corner to sort out and a little strip along there, look, where we've got to cut them all. So that'll be fine. We've also just put this up, this blind thing here. Let's show you. Let me get the rod for it. Hold on. Just got the rod here. Like that. And all you do is you stick it through the end there. And you give it a little twist. And out she comes. There we go. There we go. Just leave that hanging like that. Let's show you how it's fixed. It's only 4 bolts. Looking up there, look, that's it, look. And all you got is these 2 brackets there. There's one that end, obviously, with 2 raw bolts they are. Coming along now. And literally just the other end, exactly the same again, look. Just 2 raw bolts. And yeah, nice and simple to fix. And gives you a nice big canopy. Because we normally have Gary's daughter Olivia sitting out here as well. And she can't really be in the sun sort of thing. So it's ideal for that sort of thing. So yeah, we're looking for some new garden furniture. I've still got the grouting to do yet. You reckon a slate grey, Sharon, don't you? Grouting.
Dark.
She reckons a dark grout. I was thinking more of pretty much the same. But I suppose we'll...
See what's available.
I think it's about £27 a tub, and I think I need about 5 tubs or maybe even 6 tubs to do this area here. So
will it be cancelled like flights?
Oh, yeah. Don't have the ump, baby. Right, so that's that. Right, let's have a sit down, baby. A little bit fresh out here at the moment, but you can see blue sky for a change. It's going to be a nice day, baby. And we'd just like to say hello to Callum and Mark Williams, Sharon.
Correct. Good morning. Yep.
He sent me a couple of emails. I did see the other email, Callum, and... I did forget to actually do it because I've got so much on at the moment, as you can imagine. And but there you go. I just mentioned you. Hello, buddy. Or the pair of you. And I hope you enjoy the videos. Green tea.
Yorkshire tea.
Yeah, I normally drink that. But as I say, I normally drink decaf tea now because I drink so much tea that it sort of builds up in you after a while. And I had it back when I was about 21, 22 years old.
You're delicate, aren't you?
Well, of course I'm delicate, baby. I'm a little flower, aren't I? I used to have tea made out of tea leaves, and it was a really strong tea sort of thing. I, throughout the day, I used to have cups and cups of it, and it built up, and then I got palpitations after a while. You remember that?
Yeah.
And I went on the stress test at the hospital with all the ECG. They said, there's nothing wrong with you. Are you drinking a lot of coffee? I said, no, I don't really drink coffee. I said, but I drink a lot of tea. And then they said, oh, lay off that for a few months, which I did, and that was it. So, but over a period of years and years, If you are a big tea drinker, or even coffee drinkers, even worse, I think, Sharon, that it can build up on you.
There you go. It's never built up on me, though.
No, it hasn't, is it? Well, you don't probably drink as much as me, Sharon. Because every time I get an issue at work or whatever, or a problem, come on, get the kettle on. Yeah?
You're still saying it now.
Yeah, well, there you go. So, but the decaf has sorted me out. It's not quite as strong, the decaf, is it, Sharon?
I don't know, I've not drunk it.
Yeah. But, we drink the almond milk, we don't have normal milk anymore. So, but I do have the odd green tea now and again, so that's what I'm drinking today. And but you made it by mistake, baby. Anyway, so the chap who was going to clear that raised bed for us, I think you saw him in one of our previous videos, never come back. So he's left us with 2 bags of I was praising him up as well, wasn't I?
Yeah, but the thing is, you helped him fix his car and told him what to do with his car.
I told him, yeah, he had a problem with his car and his transit van. He said, I can't get it in gear and all that. And I said, well, I know the solution to that. And I showed him my gearbox video for the transit video, where a lot of people suffer, can't get it in first or fourth or fifth gear or reverse or whatever. And he didn't email me. He's never spoke to me personally because I don't use Facebook, but Gary goes on Facebook. And he said to Gary, he's done what he said in the video. He said it's absolutely sorted his transit van out. So there we go. I saved him money there because I think he was going to get rid of it, scrap the van or something, or sell it or whatever. And so that sorted him out. And as I said, he was due to come round on a Tuesday, and it poured down rain. We said leave it to the Wednesday. Wednesday turned up, and he never turned up. Thursday come up, he never turned up. Gary was messaging him, and apparently he said he was moving out of the area and going back to Leicester, where he come from. And I've not had no contact with the chap, as I say, because I've always looked after him. I give him a bit more money than what he charged and all that. He closed down his Facebook account in his name, Gary said. Because I said, I don't know. I didn't go on Facebook. Because he started up his own group for his like waste disposal or whatever. Gary said, oh, he's closed down his account and he's shut down his Facebook profile. I said, oh, so obviously I'm left with two bags of rubbish, 2 tonne of earth out the front in bags, which he was going to take away, which I'd already paid for. And I say, Gary had emailed him.
You paid him?
Yeah. That was all part of the first part of the job show.
Unbelievable.
But he said he was going to come back and... sorry, that was the second job, because we had him once before,
which he'd done a good job.
Second time, he even done a good job. But he said he had to leave the stuff out the front because he'd come round in his car with his friend. He didn't have his transit van. So he said he'll come back. And anyway, that's another story. So then in between him shutting down his account, Gary said, oh, we've got the raised bed to sort of take down and clear and for the extension for the workshop, which he said he was going to come round. And he wasn't going to come round, he said, because he had a family bereavement, or not bereavement, the family illness or something, and he had to be there with them. So his two helpers or whatever, he was going to pay to come round and do it. So they never turned up. And then Gary tried to get in contact with him, and he shut the account down, as I said to you. So we naturally thought he was going back to Leicester, because he'd messaged Gary before that, saying that he was going to go back to Leicester. Anyway, Gary runs a group on Facebook, a for sale group, right? Listen to this one. So don't forget, he shut down his group, what we had access to, because I did add him as a friend on Facebook, because Gary said, oh, he's put a picture of the work he's done here. So for me to see that, I had to join his group. Anyway, so Gary had a message from a chap wanting to put an advert in his for sale group. It was something Waste Disposers or something like that it was called. So obviously, Gary being the administrator of his group, he had a look at it, but he couldn't see the content. He clicked on the group and it said, you don't have access to this group. Anyway, what it looks like he'd done, he'd blocked Gary from Facebook, because Gary was also a member of his original group and Gary was new at his profile. So he couldn't see his other profile anymore. And then Gary said to me, he told me what had happened. So Gary then said to me, you have a look at his, this, I'm sure this is him. Because I tried to have a look. I couldn't see it either. Apparently, it blocked me as well for absolutely no reason. Probably because he had 2 tonne of bleaking earth out here to move. But because Gary was administrator of his group and he ran the group, he could see his profile and it said, oh, Ling comes from Lincoln, originally from Leicester. Who was it? It's the same bloody bloke, wasn't it? So he hadn't moved away. He'd started up in a different group under a different name. So if you are watching, Jack, thanks very much for dropping me in the crap. Hey.
Yeah, come and clear the mess that you've been paid for.
2 bleating tons of earth out there, which we paid for. I'll give you more than, I think you quoted 110 quid. I ended up giving them 150 quid or something like that, shall, just to clear that. And they're still sitting out there now.
But don't get the time out there looking, sort of trying to sort out his roof.
Thanks that I've spent time looking on your roof and told you where to look for your bleating convertible. Because you had no idea about what the problem was. The roof wouldn't go up or down. And I went online and found the research and found the problem. And give it to you, and you pass it on, because I see you sold that car, that convertible, and you also put in the information. I think it's this fuse, blah blah blah, and this module. All what I told you. So thanks very much for that, Jack. So if you're going to do jobs for someone, especially nice people, don't turn them over, mate, because it can come back to haunt you in the way of a flicking YouTube video, Sharon.
That's it.
Isn't it? So I'm stuck now, and I admit, just like.
I must say, good morning to Woodall Spa Post Office.
Oh, yeah, well, our post lady came around the other day and I was out the front filming a car and filming a car video, and she said to me, "Oh, I was watching Facebook the other day," she said, "and in the office, and you and Sharon come up doing a showering video."
Oh, hello, it was me first, wasn't it?
Yeah, but I was talking to her, but she said, "Can't I actually know Sharon?" But there you go. So, did you know the woman? Hannah, wasn't it? Gary said it was Hannah, yeah. So she don't know what he do the round. Apparently, listen to this one, the people in the office are having to come out and do the rounds because everyone's off on bloody up, taking the option to go off on furlough, Sharon.
Yeah, because there's one person you always see about, isn't it? Yeah. Well, now you're thinking about it, it's just one postman.
Furlough. So now our holiday's been cancelled yet again.
We was going to do everything. I've even got the tests in there.
We've had to buy all the tests and all that, and that's not cheap. This is becoming a bit of a joke now, to be honest with you.
I'm willing to pay that to go and see my daughter, follow the rules.
And all this traffic light thing. Where's this all come from? Traffic light. When does a country become a bleating colour, a traffic light?
All I can say is, in EasyJet, they have been very good. They know, well, I look every morning, and to slot my days is very straightforward, so...
It's not a point, Sharon. It's getting a bit ridiculous now. Yeah. Left hand don't know what the right hand's doing.
And
it's
got to be suffering EasyJet and all that, haven't they?
Sharon, as I've said before, folks, this is the Third World War. We're going through the Third World War now, which is a chemical warfare where everyone's going to be controlled. And I done a video back in 2015, Sharon. Yeah? I'll leave a little clip of it in here, right? I'll just show you it. Little clip in it in here where I said everything's gone too far and we need a big reset button, right? You watch this. I was fuming, Sharon, weren't I?
What am I going to say? I know.
I've got an appointment to go to the doctor's for a blood test.
Oh, my God.
No, listen. I've got to tell them.
No, you have. It's ridiculous.
Went to the doctor. I had an appointment. Had a letter. So all the paperwork. They generate a letter. They send it out to you. Yeah, she's got to have a blood test. 8:40, wasn't it?
No,
9:30.
That's what you was like.
Listen. 9:30. Was it Monday?
Tuesday.
I've never ever...
Should have stuck to his instincts. It would have been 25 hours early.
I've never ever, ever been late to a doctor's appointment. And this is basically just a blood test with a nurse, basically. You go in there, you're in there however long it takes to get some blood out your arm and you're out the door. Anyway, cut a long story short. She was here again, weren't you? You was here. I think she was the catalyst that made me late. And because I looked at the book, I said to Sharon, I said, what time's my appointment? She said, I don't know, it's in the book. And it was 9:30. And I noticed that the appointment was at 9:30. So I quickly jumped in the car. I've zoomed down there. I've walked in the doctor's surgery, our local doctor's surgery. And as I've walked in, young lady behind the counter, I said, oh, Martin, yeah, knew my name. I didn't know the lady's name off the top of my head. She said, oh, Martin, yeah, just take a seat. So she obviously knew I was coming. And as I sat down, I said, oh, I think I'm a little bit late. A few minutes late.
I'm himself there. Yeah. I'm yourself.
No, hold on, I ain't finished yet. I'm being honest, I'm being up front. I'm going to a doctor's surgery to get treatment. Yeah? So anyway, I sit down there. She says to me, you're quite a bit late, aren't you? I said, well, in actual fact, I'm 8 minutes late. She said, you'll have to rebook. I've sat there and I've looked around this doctor's surgery. There's nobody in there. There's one person, one chap, sitting opposite me.
So there was somebody in there.
Shut up, Sharon. I'm telling the story. It's empty. Listen. It's empty. I said, look. I said, there's no one here. She says, yes, but your appointment was for 9:30, and it's a 10-minute slot. You're 8 minutes into that, you've missed your window. She says, that's the next chap sitting opposite you. This other chap was the one at 9:40. So why didn't she put him at 9:30 when my slot was, because I wasn't there, and the place is totally empty? Anyway, with that, she's had to book my appointment or rebook it. We're at the start of the month now. It's had to be rescheduled for the end of the month. Because afterwards, what happens is you have a blood test, and then next week I was automatically booked in for the review. They call it a review. So that's gone cancelled. So I've had to go now on the 21st. What's the date today, Sharon?
10.
But this was about the
7th.
21st. Now, this is systems. This isn't bleating about. You go to the doctors. I've never ever been in this situation before. And this is the 21st century when human race and things are supposed to be progressing. And here we are now. I've had to move because of a system in place because no doubt that the doctor's got to have a certain amount of time of each people. It's all done on computer. You can't argue against the computer. It takes away common sense and integrity. Not integrity, what's the word? Intuition. Normally you go in, oh yeah, okay, fair enough. If you just hold on a couple of minutes, we'll get you in, not a problem. No, out the window, you've got to rebook. 2 months, 2 weeks in advance, I've got to rebook and then another appointment. What's that all about? This is the world we live in now. Anyway, I don't want to get on a negative now, but yeah, that really peeved me off. But this so-called 21st century world we live in. And the trouble is that us human beings, we go along with it. We let them do it to us. We let them. It's not the people in the doctor's surgery. It's not their fault. We implement the rules of society. And then, we're confined to a little song. If you ever heard the song called Little Boxes on the Hillside. Little boxes made of ticky-tacky. Little boxes, little boxes. Little boxes all the same. There's a green one and a pink one and the blue one and the yellow one and they all made out of Tracy and ticky tacky and they all look just the same. Now you might think
that's like that.
Hey?
And then you hum that to her.
What's that?
Little boxes.
Yeah. Little out. Listen. Now I taught Tracy that when she was a kid.
Jimmy loved that as a baby.
No,
It was Jimmy. Thank you. Anyway. I'm the mother.
Jimbo. Listen to this. Now that's a kid's song. What we know as a kid's song, it's a political song. It's not a kid's song. It is a kid's song because it's Little Boxes Ticky Tacky. And if you watch it on YouTube, I think a bloke sung it called Pete Seegers. Yes. Hey, she even knows. I've drummed it into her. And it's about living your life. And you're put into little boxes and you're told what to do throughout your life. This is the system we live in. Go on YouTube and type in Little Boxes. Watch the video. And it's not. Although it's a nice little nursery rhyme, so to call it. A very important message behind it. Pete Seegers, who was big in the 60s and the 50s as an activist for humans, and talking about humans. But this world, what we've moved into now, I tell you what, I see it. I remember back in the 1970s. Now, do you remember the miners' strike back in the early 1970s in the UK? Well, the UK. Hey, listen.
Talk to Tracy.
Tracy's had to move out of shop because she's doing a bit of a feeding with Emily. Anyway, back in the 70s in the UK, we had like 3 day a week, lots of miner strikes and stuff like that. And we used to sit in our living room when it was so cold. We used to sit around a candle to keep warm. That's how cold it was in the early 1970s. Sit around a candle. The whole family sit around a candle to keep warm.
What did you do when it was really cold?
When it was really cold, we used to light it.
No! Don't laugh, it's not funny. You've been there for years.
No, anyway, that was a little joke, obviously.
It's not funny.
What I was going to say is I remember being a kid in the 70s. And like this was about that same time. Like this is real now. This is just how I was thinking back in the 70s as a 6, 7, 8 year old kid. And I remember thinking to myself, watching all these bleeding miners' strikes and all that, and pay increases, people wanting more money, because this is what they're told we have to do in this system we live in. And I remember saying to myself, well, what happens if everyone gets pay rises every year and every year? Where does it stop? Where does it end? And this is the trouble with this capitalist, money-orientated, time-monitored world we live in, is that it reaches a threshold. And the threshold, when it gets... You can't obviously pay someone and get an increase every year, because where does it end? You lose the true value of stuff. And it's all about what we want in the 21st century now. We're at that point of excess where everybody's exploiting everything right to the hilt, and what we need now is a big reset button like that. And unfortunately, the world's reset button is a bloody world war. And that's what the reset button is, that... It's a real, and because it kills everything, drops everything, all the system back down to a bare minimum, and the system start to build up. With all the technology we've got in this world, in this 21st century of which we've got, the trouble of it is that it should be used to help people get better. It should be helped to ease the burdens of life. It should make people's lives easier. What's happened with technology is, in my opinion, is that it's got in the hands of people who are using it to make money out of other people. That's what's happened here. And then you've got corporations that run the world. Let's look at policing, for example. A police constable, when you watch the old carry-on films or the black and white films in the 70s, 60s and 50s, the old constable used to walk down the street whistling a tune, and if he sees someone doing something wrong, he'll blow a whistle, other people go, and people will run away because they know he's the police officer, he's the law. Now, you've got them sitting in vans, they're under plainclothes, looking to photograph you to try and catch you at the speed, so that they can earn money, earn revenue, because every police station is a corporation. It is not there as a law body to make you feel safe and to protect you. It is there to generate money. It is a registered corporation. What am I doing talking about all this? I was turning into a rant, isn't it?
Turning into it, it is a rant.
Anyway, cut a long story short. That's why I advocate what we do on our channel. We just mess about. Happy New Year. Yeah. We play about on our channel. We get involved with life and
you've
people.
And
all this texting. All this, what's that all about?
Calm down.
What's this texting like? And
you ain't gonna get nowhere like that.
Look at youngsters. Look at youngsters. They're like that. Even the adults. They're like that. You can ever sit on. You ever go on a train or a public transport? No, I haven't for a long time. I went on the train a few months back, didn't we, Sharon? We went down to London, was it?
Mm.
And everyone's stuck in. I want to look out the blinking window.
We did, didn't we?
9 times out of 10. You see keyboard fighters on the internet. I'm doing it again, aren't I?
Yeah, can you
keyboard
say goodbye?
Fighters on the internet, typing stuff in.
LOL!
LOL. Oh, that's another one, Sharon. LOL.
Stop.
Have you ever seen, if you go on Facebook, listen to this one. You go on Facebook, when someone's trying to have a go at someone, or write a snidey comment, right, listen to this. I've seen it many, many a time. They write a comment, if they don't agree with what that person said, they finish it off with LOL, or a smiley face. Or put a few kisses. In other words, I don't agree with what you're saying, and I don't like what you're saying, but and I've had a go at your back, but I'll put a little LOL behind it. And that makes you think. But you know that, because we're all wise to it. We're all wise to it. And then we do it back. And before you know it, you're not talking how you normally would be talking.
Before
because
you
know
it, everyone's laughing
then everyone
out loud.
Everyone else is coming. Everyone else is coming to agree or disagree with either one of you. Then it's a battle.
I can't get a word in with you.
What's that all about?
Say
what's
goodbye.
It all about? This is the 21st century.
Mark, hey? Say goodbye for Christ's sake. I've people won't have survived this long.
There we go. That was 2015, that was, believe it or not. Although I uploaded it in 2019, the actual recording was done in 2015.
Yeah, that's our little Emily, and she's 7 now.
Yeah, 7 now, yeah. She was a little 9-month-old baby then, wasn't she, Cheryl? Anyway, so it's, although it's a Butler's Empire video, it's a little bit of a downer one today, Cheryl, isn't it?
I'm on a major downer.
No, don't be on a major downer, baby. Because we've got to look at the positives at the end of the day, yeah? We've got a lovely place, we've got a lovely family. We've got
disputing that. I was so looking forward to seeing them.
Well, of course we was, baby, but we can still see them FaceTime and all that, you know?
Not the same, is it? Not the same as a paddle.
Anyway, so what's been going on with the projects and all that? Well, I've virtually finished the TGB moped now. You probably see that on my Retro Restore channel. I've got a new back tyre now, which I'm just about to put on today when it gets a little bit later. Yeah? So I've got new back tyre. What have I done to the TGB moped? New back tyre, new front tyre, new back caliper, front caliper, new brakes all round, new clutch, new barrel, new piston, new crank, plus all the other little tinkering bits as well I've had. So I should have that running today, shall I? Now, do you people enjoy us when we go out and about doing our little review videos sort of thing? Because if you do, we'll do a few more of them. Although we're not...
I ain't done a review, have we? I haven't.
Yes, you have. We've done the blinking thingy burger, the rainbow burger.
I'm delirious today.
So if we go.
Oh yeah, fish and chip shop. Yeah.
We went to Skeggy Fish and Chip Shop sort of thing, you know. If we're out and about, because normally when we're going out doing stuff like that, I don't normally take the camera, but I mean I can do, can't we, Cal?
Yeah.
So we might just do that a bit more if you enjoy them sort of videos. Where
are you liking and subscribing?
I'll tell you what. On Retro Restore, Sharon, right, listen. On Retro Restore and on Butler's Empire, the subscriber count hasn't gone up virtually at all since about January, February. What's going on?
Don't you like us? Aren't you?
I don't. No, it's not them, Sharon.
Share the love with your friends.
It's not them.
No, it's not them.
It's YouTube's algorithm.
I've told you about that.
What?
Mustn't say they're listening.
They are listening, baby. But I'm going to kick up a little fuss because at the end of the day, as I said to you before, I've seen lesser channels with not as much varied content.
Well, not nearly as many views either.
And nowhere near as many views. And they're getting regular and regular subscribers. I can't work it out. But there you go. Right, that's my green tea done, baby. Yeah?
You're not having another one straight away.
No, I'm going to sit down. I'm going to have a little ponder. Yeah?
What are you going to ponder?
I'm a vegetarian again, folks, by the way. Because I've been, as you know, I put on a couple of stone again. And before you say it, it's nothing to do with overeating. It's me testing out the reasons why I gain weight as someone who's got diabetes or type 2 diabetes. And you do tend to put on weight very easily if you've got what you call insulin resistance. I've mentioned this before in other videos, because someone says, oh, you know, you're eating rubbish again. When you see us do the takeaway foods, the Skeggy fish and chips, for example.
Fish ain't rubbish.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm talking about the chips and that, oh, you know that. Okay. And also the burger and all that. That's not what we normally eat. For example, a normal day's meal for us, right, listen, is one meal a day, maybe with a small snack around 12, between 12 and 2 o'clock, something like that. Isn't that, Sharon?
Yeah.
Sharon, what are you bending over for, baby?
Stroking Barbie.
Oh, okay. Just thought you were getting away from me. And that snack has, when we done all our dieting and all that, not dieting, when we changed our way of eating, don't forget that we weren't eating carbs, and we still have stuck to that to a certain extent, although maybe we might have had, let's have a look, what would we have eaten if we would have had a cheat date? Call it a cheat.
Bacon sandwich.
A bacon sandwich, for example,
lovely.
Yeah. And that's, don't forget, that's not every day, that may be once every 3 weeks or maybe something like that, so... So it's not the quantity of food we've eaten, but the one common denominator, listen to this, of my weight gain again, has been eating processed food, right? Now, when I say eating processed food, that's not me just eating any old random processed food with hidden this, that, the other in. This is me eating processed food, which in, you know, they've got the colour, again, the traffic light system, Sharon. Red, amber and green on the back. I always eat green under the sugar, in other words, with the low sugar. But the food is processed. And when I say the food is processed, it don't matter about the fat content, but the fats is where I believe now that you gain the weight, because you're eating unhealthy fats, fats like vegetable oils, corn oils, rapeseed oils. These oils are actually very bad for you, believe it or not, and no good for the liver. And if your liver and pancreas ain't working correctly, then you store body fat because you get insulin resistance. Even though food comes with a green traffic light for the sugar, I'm obviously boring her.
Going to wee.
That is the only common denominator in the difference, plus I've been eating meat as well. So as a result of that, I've stopped eating meat again now. I'm about 3 days into it at the moment. And I've stopped eating processed food. And already, I can feel the difference in the weight loss already in that short time, believe it or not. So if you have got an issue, because I've been trying extra hard to lose the weight over the past month or two, for example, and it's been very hard to shift 1 or 2 pounds even. But as I say, I've been eating meat and also the processed food, even though it's been in the healthy bracket for the sugars. So as soon as I've stopped eating the meat and I've stopped eating the processed food, and I've gone back to not raw foods, I've gone back to natural foods again, wholesome foods. The only processed food I eat is the Linda McCartney burgers with mozzarella, and also the vegetarian stuff like that. That's the meat substitute stuff. That's the only processed food I eat. As far as anything else is concerned, no, don't touch it. And already I can feel the difference in weight loss. So I'll be finding out at the end of the week how much I have lost. But I'm quite happy again. Before I was struggling because I was cutting back on food. And if you looked at my series of videos when I first started losing the weight back in January last year, when I lost 3 stone, I was eating masses of food. So if you've got insulin resistance, if you've got type 2 diabetes and you're putting the pounds on, stay away from processed foods, even though it's in the green band, and consider cutting out your meat for a little period of time. You ain't got to do it for a long, just go vegetarian for a month, for example. But have a go at the Linda McCartney burgers, the ones with mozzarella, and also what are they called? The Richmond vegetarian sausages. Have a go at them. You still have a fry up and all that. You still have egg. Still have your sausages. You go cauliflower hash browns. Well, you have a look at my food, what I've done in the Butler's Empire video where I said we're coming back. Just have a look at that. But I'm back on it now anyway. And also, I haven't got any achy joints anymore in that short free period of time. So there is something in this, you know, but it's just a matter of you won't find any scientific studies on it, because they don't really want you to know that. They want you on medication for a long period of time for the rest of your life, as I was told they want me on. And they was amazed when I went back and had my blood test and said, we don't know what you've done, but whatever it is, keep doing it. And I said, well, I've just corrected my diet. Not using Diabetic Association's menu, for example, because they still allow you to eat small amounts of carbs. You've got to cut the carbs out totally. Anyway, that's enough of that. Let's have a little walk around the workshop and just see what we've been up to on the scooter. Hello, she's out again. What's the matter?
That
I can't hear you.
That smells, that rose.
We've got a little rose out, have we?
Well, I pruned it back, and I pruned it back late, but it's the best it's ever looked.
Lovely. Oh, look at that little baby, look. A lovely little rose there. How's our plum tree going, baby? We've got little buds on the plough here. They're coming
from...
Yeah, they are plums.
I'm sure, you only have to touch them and they fall off. So...
Yeah, well, they are plums, Shell. That's the plums, baby. Isn't it?
Well, we've lost a lot.
What?
Plums.
Yeah.
Yeah, look, there's another one on the floor, look.
Yeah, well, they are plums, though, I think. Yeah, that's a little plum, isn't it, folks?
It's a little plum.
Yeah? Little plums. He's in that bush again. So, yeah, we're getting there, folks.
Show the pears. They are coming on, actually.
Oh, the pears?
I'm very impressed.
Come
I
on,
will be eating these.
Lovely pear, Cheryl. Oh, yeah. That's a little tree like this. Look, they're the pears there. Look. There you go.
Got a lot on there, this.
Yeah, this is a lot more healthier this year, this tree, isn't it, Cheryl?
And there's my little pots my grandchildren planted.
Yeah, yeah. Do that with the kids. Look, rather than blink and put them on computer games, get them out in the garden, get some pots and start growing stuff. Look, is that lupin?
Yeah.
Little buttercups. No, what are they? Buttercups over there?
Oh, they're pansies.
Oh, that's a pansy, is it?
I might pull out something in it. Today.
They've all come out recently, look.
One little pot.
Do them with the kids, they love them, look.
They did
enjoy. Aren't they, Barney? Eh?
And I will say they're the best they've ever been.
Yeah. There you go. There you go, baby.
I might do some weeding today, come out and do some weeding.
Well, there's enough of them, Shell, look, all around there.
That cross, I'll be pulling them out.
I've got to sort your lawnmower out, Shell, and I'll come over here, look.
Yeah, that dog's been rattling as well on the side.
Yeah, I noticed the bracket had come off. It's looking a little bit worse for wear now. It's been real well battered and well used. The lawnmower there, look, it's all scraped off the side again.
Sounded all spongy.
Spongy, yes, it sounds spongy, baby.
Gurgly, like when you squeeze a sponge.
I don't understand.
What's
this thing? Yeah, I've got, look, the bolt's falling out of that, look. Looking a bit rough now, baby, isn't it? Your old Briggs and Shell. You don't want to do it, start up on there, Shell. It will suck that plastic up. So I'll give it a prime.
Yeah, because then you'll feel it.
What? Did you say? One. Oh, plenty of petrol in it.
Yeah, I filled it up and it's not working.
Five, six, one more. Seven, go on in.
Look at ants on it, look.
Yeah, ants, covered in ants. Go on, baby. Oh,
that doesn't feel right.
That was going to start then.
Doesn't feel right.
Doesn't it?
No.
Wait there, let me get the tripod, shall you? You hadn't hit anything, have you?
No.
No?
No, I was working. It ran out of petrol then when I...
Oh, it's the wrong lever, isn't it? It's a drive lever. It's all right. Nothing wrong with that. You might... Oh. There's nothing wrong with that. You might have had loads of grass caught up underneath it.
No, because I dented it. And I always pull it through. I filled it and it just wouldn't restart.
Yeah, but look. There's nothing wrong with that, baby. It's a drive work, hold on. Yeah, that works. Because don't forget, I had this whole engine stripped down, didn't I?
I don't know, how weird though.
Well, I don't know. It might be because it... I don't
but
know.
This sounded...
That can't sound woolly, Shad. That's only...
No, there's no noise. There was like gurgling, like it was wet.
Well, I'm going to take the air filter off, baby, because you... Did you stick your finger underneath there, did you say?
No. But then
I thought I'd just seen you stick your finger underneath there.
I pressed the thing to see for the noise.
Oh, because under there is a sponge.
But what I'm thinking...
Which is dry, by the way.
It would have dried out by now.
No, not if it's petrol oil. No.
No, wouldn't
no.
it?
No.
Well, that's very strange.
How strange and mysterious.
Because I thought you used one of Gary's that he's up... brought in and oh
that's fine baby
oh that's pleased me
I'll put a screw in there for you
yeah because that does make
and then you'll be back to normal
there's Dale, I'll give it a cut later.
Oh, Shell.
Don't put him on.
He's curling one out, Shell.
It's not nice, is it? Would you like people to watch you go? They might be eating their dinner.
Eh?
They might be eating their dinner.
Yeah. Get the old scooper, Shell. Hold on. Wait there. You've got to have one of these, folks. We're going to get it. You've got to have one of these, look. Just pick it up, look. And I normally just lob it in the bushes. There you go. Happy days. Pooper scooper. What are you doing over there, baby? Having a nose? He won't like you in here, Shell.
He won't like it when I kick him out.
Oh, isn't it warm in here? Hey?
Oh, isn't it? There's a sauna.
Isn't it warm?
I was just seeing if that...
Shout, all the gear, no idea.
Yeah.
We've still got to do his engine there. He's waiting to get that vapor blaster. We can't find a vapor blaster. Want to get the old TZR back, engine back in the TZR and put that back together.
Does it have to be vapor blasted then?
Yeah, it really wants to be vapor blasted. I tried soda blasting it and it didn't come out very well. So that's something we've got to do. Now, what's Shell? I've got what one should I was going to work on this one next. Yeah, the little one I bought from the auction many years ago.
And that one you got from the auction, didn't you?
Yeah, I got them both from the auction, didn't I?
Both the same day, wasn't it?
But then I got this one here in the front there, so I wouldn't imagine that one would take too much to get back to.
I'd say do that blue one.
Yeah, I'll strip it all down, obviously, but.
The simple reason it's easier to get out than that one. It's more straightforward, just pull that one out.
Yeah, well that was my thinking as well, Sharon.
And it's bigger.
Yeah, so I mean that one's all there, and so I think that basically just need a strip down and a clean up. The plastics look pretty much okay. Although there was a little crack on there, I noticed, but if push comes to shove, oh, and there's a little slight bit out there maybe. So I've got a couple of little bits of repair to do on that, but and seat cover. I need a new seat cover on that one. But I think that should be pretty much all there. That'll restore back to pretty much original. When I eventually come to do these two RDs there.
What, my bike?
Your bike and my bike, baby, yeah.
Well, I don't have a motorbike.
I'll do them both together, I think. Because they're pretty much the same.
What's this one?
That's Gary's NRG.
Oh.
So, again, that's just need the bodywork painted on it. Pick that back up down there, baby.
I'll stop doing that.
Hey? Eh?
Gets on my nerves.
No, it don't. No, please don't have a go at me, baby. It's a bit of comp.
Times I've told you about it, it's not funny anymore. You've done everything.
I bet they laugh in the comment section, baby. We went for a two and a half mile walk yesterday, Shea, didn't we?
Yeah.
We went out at sort of half eight, come back about half nine, didn't we, last night?
Yeah, that's a lovely walk around there.
Yeah, just nice taking Barney out, wasn't it?
Even though he does bark at every dog he sees.
He does, doesn't he? And he can't hear us tell him off, Sharon, can he? Hey.
No.
Yeah, with this here, folks, as you can see, the edging. Here he goes, barking again, look. I've got to, when it gets further down the end here, obviously. This is obviously thicker earth here, look, because it weren't totally level, obviously. So I'll just have to chamfer that in and then reseed it so there ain't such a big transition there sort of thing, you know. But we're getting there. There's 14 to go there. 14 left to go there. 14 whole tiles. And then we've got to cut the strip in from down there all the way down there sort of thing, just to the end there. And that's what we wanted that chap to take away. Look, we contacted him to dismantle that and get rid of the raised bed, basically, because I want the log cabins, the new ones, to come right along here, right along to the end there and there, basically. That was going to be it. So, but like the patio, I'll probably end up doing it with blinking self now. But that's the way it goes, isn't it, Barney? And every time I was doing cementing down here, he comes out, he stands straight in it.
He's lovely, isn't he?
Isn't he? Straight in it, Shell. I'll tell you what though, without this, Andy told us, you've got to have one of these.
At least it'd be done up, wouldn't they, go up for sale?
Oh yeah, when we're finished, but I say they won't get... I've got another one of these around the corner still, so I'll get them repainted and refurbished and all that, and then I'll out them. But I bought them cheap anyway, so it's done a service. Definitely don't want to be mixing this up by hand, Shell, yeah. And there you go, and there's the old canopy, folks. Look at that, look. Nice little addition.
Yeah, I want some more of that rattan furniture, I think.
Yeah, as I say, we had these old chairs here, which we're...
Because that actually, I haven't got a cover, but I'm getting a cover for that this year. That's been out all through the bad weather, hasn't it? The only thing that got taken in was the glass.
Yeah.
And that's...
But we want a couple of lounges out here as well, don't we? A couple of sun lounges out here. We're happy with that.
Nice swing chair.
Are we happy with that table?
Well, Well, if you're going to get in, you'd like to do it all, mightn't you?
Yeah, but we're not too...
I have been looking for chairs and you can't...
Yeah, but you can spend hundreds of pounds on this sort of stuff, Sharon.
I know that. Should have got it in the winter.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, I've seen stuff come up at auctions as well, but... Like, I'm a member of many auction lists around the country sort of thing, but it means having to go and pick it up there. That's the thing, if you do buy some cheap, you know? Mm. And we want some heavy-duty stuff as well, because we've had all the cheap plastic ones in the past.
I'm surprised how strong they are.
What?
The rattan.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the way I'm going, I think, because I'm make some cushions. Wood, you've got to keep treating. That, you've got to do nothing to. And that's the perfect thing for me. And it's light to move about.
But we want a nice big table out here as well, don't we? Nice big table, couple of sun loungers, shall, and you'll be a brew. You'll be in Cyprus here, baby, especially when the weather's like this.
I know, but I just miss them so much.
Yeah. Anyway.
It's not the Cyprus, it's the family I want to see.
Yeah.
If they were down the road, I wouldn't be going to Cyprus.
Well, we might be going to Spain, we don't know, do we?
I've always been happy here, which I am happy here, but I just want to see...
We might have been out and about doing vlogs, Sharon.
Well, that's the thing we could maybe do when they're back, maybe, weekends away.
Yeah, well, we did start to do that, didn't we? We started doing the odd weekend away, but then suddenly there was loads of work which needed doing around the house. So don't forget, this year, what have we done this year? We've done all the upstairs bathroom.
If any travel companies don't want us to rate their hotels, we're quite welcome to do that.
Yeah, rate my bed and breakfast.
Yeah, I'm happy to do that.
We had loads of, what have we done this year? We've done loads of work this year. Apart from this, all the plumbing had to be altered upstairs. I had to run a big 4-inch waste for...
Oh, lots been done here, decorating.
Then I've done all the bathroom upstairs. Then we've done all the bathrooms upstairs. Then I had to put new water pumps in downstairs on the immersion heater and all that sort of stuff. Mm. So there's been loads of work going on. That was the downstairs carpet on my mum's, the old part of the house, wasn't it? The living room, the small living room area. I've got that still to do. We got the new control panel for the hot tub, which cost about £400, I think, if I remember rightly, shall, wasn't it? That's still, but again, to do that, I've got to clear all that out. And I've still got the trotter doors laying on the top of the hot tub
new
at the moment.
New roof, I'm going to have this stuff. What's it called?
New roof's got to go on
I
here.
I don't want the wood. What's that stuff called?
Shingles.
That's the one. I like hers next door, that pattern.
Then I had shingles, didn't I, shall?
Oh!
You hit Barney?
Sorry,
you hit Barney, baby. You was waving that bling wand about, weren't you?
Sorry, darling. so have that put on the roof, wood with shingles.
Yeah, so that roof's got to be... I'll take the roof off and then redo that.
This will all be done out the front.
This is virtually there now, as you can see, apart from the grouting. So that's...
That all needs a good paint.
What, this again? That's all we painted. Then we've got to start the patio raised cement... base on there.
Oh, sorry, Trace, I haven't got time to come and see you.
But no, this is all what we've got to do. This is all what we've got to do. And also, don't forget, all that takes money as well, Sharon, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You know?
Well, everything takes blinking money.
So that's what we're doing. Just another busy day, baby. Oh, well. I think it's time for a cup of tea, Sharon. Come on, baby. Get the kettle on.
Should have married a chimp. They make teas, don't they?
Get the kettle
advert.
Get the kettle on. Come on. See you in a minute, folks. Oh, right, let's come in here. Turn the old light on. Still a bit of a mess in here, folks. And here's the scooter there, as you can see. I've got the new back wheel now, the new back tyre to go on there. And the only thing I've got to do is to reject the carb, but I'm going to need to obviously get it on the road first. The seat lock mechanism is now working off of the key, as you can see. There you go, it's just pinged up, look. That weren't working before. There we go, that's locked. There you go. So that now works. There we go. Yeah, so I've had so much work done. New front tyre, as you can see. Look, it's still got the blinking label on it, look. So that's a new front tyre, new back tyre. In the engine there, it's got a brand new crank in it. It's got a new barrel in there. New piston. It's a 60cc kit, it's been de-restricted. Everything works on it, it's got a full MOT on it. So all I've got to do is put a little bit of tax on it and a bit of insurance. So that's it, folks. I've got the cylinder head here for the trotter van, which I want to get going again. People keep asking, oh, when are you going to do the trotter van? When I know that, I've got all these things on the go. I've still got Sharon's interior to put in a Astra at the moment. Again, I'm still waiting for that Bowden cable. I ordered it the 27th of May, I ordered it, and today is the 9th of June, and it still hasn't turned up. So all the interior can't go in until I've obviously got that Bowden cable. I know I could use the old one, but obviously I'm a bit dubious about taking the one out of the old seat and putting it in the new seat, because you can never tell, can you, if that's going to go. And it'll be a big job just to get it all out again, so I'd rather put a brand new cable on in there. Right, I'll leave it here, folks. I've been rambling on just for long enough now. We're a little bit upset, as I say, because our holiday's been cancelled again. With this, well, whatever's going on. I'm not even going to talk about it. I've got my own versions of what I think's going on anyway, but that's enough of that anyway. Anyway, folks, thanks very much. Don't forget, if you do like our videos, do hit the subscribe button and ring that little notification bell and set your preferences to all. And that way, when we do upload a video, you'll get a little message come up on your phone or whatever, or computer, saying that we've uploaded. And that'll be great. Thanks very much indeed. I'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.